We're talking best supplements for Olympic weightlifters and powerlifters. We are hitting CNS fatigue hard. I'll show you how to fix it, and we're starting right now. What is going on? My name is David Barr. If you're looking to get bigger, faster, stronger, get leaner, go longer, hit that subscribe and then the little bell so you don't miss the latest tips and tricks. And today we are talking CNS fatigue. This one needs to be fixed because so many people experience it. We don't really know what it is, but there is a prospective solution that we're going to hit hard. In this part of the series, we are talking CNS fatigue. It is a problem for everybody. We need to fix it, but some people are actually creating a new problem and trying to fix it. So we'll fix the original problem of CNS fatigue, and then we'll fix the prospective fix that's actually causing more of a problem. So there's a lot of fixes going on. Let's get right to it. At the end of this video, I'll show you what I do with my clients and athletes. We'll give you a three-step checklist so you can take full advantage of these tips. So this one kicked off when I got a private tour of the Olympic Training Center, the now defunct Olympic weightlifting facility. Very cool. And I was told that each lifter had their own platform, and you could kind of get a sense of which lifter had which platform based on what was sitting on it. So there was an old pair of wraps on one, old pair of shoes on another, and on a third, there was actually a bottle of supplements. Now, what was weird was that this was a regular bottle of supplements that anybody could buy off the shelf. Now, you have to think that these athletes, some of the top athletes on the planet, have full athlete development programs around them. So they have, you know, strength coaches, sport coaches, psychologists, they have everything, nutritionists, and they went around all of that and actually just bought something off the shelf. The problem with this one is that it had high dose BCAAs. And this is really where I started to get the idea that, hey, a lot of weightlifters and powerlifters seem to love their BCAAs, and this is what creates a problem. Now, real quick, before we get into the problem, the whole purpose of this series is to introduce neuroscience in terms of strength, power, speed, that kind of thing, because right now we're in the dark ages and we really need to fix that. There's a lot of info out there, so I want to give you a nice, gentle introduction to neuroscience, not the electrophysiology that we're currently applying, but the actual neurochemistry that we can apply to improve performance. Want it to be like a warm bath, nice and easy, nice and gentle for you, nothing too crazy. Now, you're actually probably familiar with a little basic neurochemistry that relates to this problem because it comes back to the whole serotonin fatigue thing. And you probably know this based on the Thanksgiving dinner myth, the idea that turkey has a lot of the essential amino acid tryptophan. Tryptophan gets converted to the neurotransmitter serotonin. That causes fatigue and that somnolent effect that we get. Makes us feel sleepy, sedated, that kind of thing. Well, unfortunately, that myth just isn't true because every complete protein has tryptophan in it. So if turkey were to do it, pretty much every type of complete protein would do this to us. So it's not totally accurate, but it does lay the foundation for basic neuroscience that we can use and manipulate for our performance enhancement. And I think a lot of weightlifters and powerlifters are using BCAAs because it comes back to ways to mitigate CNS fatigue based on the whole serotonin tryptophan thing. And this actually comes from research, but the research is performed in endurance athletes, not lifters. Very, very different. But what the research showed was that we could potentially mitigate some fatigue, some performance fatigue, by loading the body with BCAAs, branched chain amino acids. And they would basically counter the effect of the tryptophan and the serotonin. So a lot of athletes are using BCAAs for this purpose. There is a fundamental problem with that, is that the BCAAs and the tryptophan, they're actually blocking access to our CNS, our central nervous system. They're blocking access of a key amino acid called tyrosine. And what tyrosine does is it converts to a fantastic neurotransmitter, the one you want, called dopamine. So if we have the BCAAs and the tryptophan blocking the tyrosine from getting to our brain and our spinal cord, the CNS, then we're not going to have as much dopamine. That's a problem for your performance. Because dopamine is not just responsible for motivation and pleasure, it's also responsible for motor learning, motor skill acquisition. And when you start to mess with motor stuff, then you're going to have problems with performance. You don't want to decrease that. We want to potentially increase motor skill acquisition, motor skill learning, but we don't want to decrease it. And that's exactly what we're doing when we overload the body with BCAAs. Now, real quick, if you're interested in BCAAs, and you probably should be, I have a whole other video. I cover that. A lot of people are using it wrong, using it, shooting themselves in the foot, really. And I go into some of my research real quick, give you three quick tips for how to use BCAAs. I don't sell them. No conflict of interest or anything like that, but be sure to check out the video in the top right. And stay tuned for the bonus tip that's coming at the end of this video. You don't want to miss this one. It's going to change a lot. So the big solution here, big shout out to the late Charlie Francis, track coach. If you're interested in speed, check out everything he's ever done. Fantastic resource. But he introduced me to the idea of tyrosine back in the day. Not personally, but in some of his writing. I had no idea what this stuff was, what it did, and in my research with amino acids, started to realize that, hey, this idea has some legs to it, so we need to start exploring this further, and especially with regard to neurotransmitters. Because, again, we are in the dark ages when it comes to neurotransmitters, neuromanipulation. We could do this for cognitive enhancement, for intelligence, for focus, all kinds of things. But right now, we are talking strength, power, speed. So we want to optimize our dopamine through tyrosine, and that's going to give us that performance boost that we're after, mitigate that CNS fatigue, and definitely get rid of the whole BCAA shooting ourselves in the foot idea. That needs to die. Now, real quick, are you using tyrosine BCAAs to mitigate central fatigue? I want to hear what you're using. Let me know in the comments below. So the actual fix, the way I do it, the way I use it for myself, my clients, my athletes, is to use tyrosine and BCAAs in a one-to-one ratio about an hour before my workout, before my lift. And that way you could have a potential syngenic effect. This is a bonus tip. This is a new idea came up with. It's going to change a lot. It's the idea of using supplements in different doses, combinations, and times to create novel effects. It's not just synergistic. It's not just a boosted performance effect. It's going to be a complete interaction of the different ingredients to get a bigger bang for our buck. Something that we're not expecting. We don't see it coming, but it just happens. It's a fantastic effect. So I'll talk about that more in other videos. But this is actually going to help out, especially if you're using caffeine, pre-workout stims, that kind of thing. So the syngenic effect is going to be a combination of pre-workout stim like caffeine, the tyrosine, the BCAAs. So you're blocking the tryptophan from getting across, but you're not having that harmful decrease in dopamine. We want that dopamine to increase our motor learning, and that's the key. So once we start combining these ingredients, we're going to have these potentially novel effects that we're not expecting. Because remember, caffeine is going to increase norepinephrine, epinephrine, our catecholamines, right? Including dopamine. You may know them as noradrenaline, adrenaline, respectively. But in North America, talk about epi, norepi, fight or flight response. And this is key, not only for acute performance, but also for baking in those gains, really making sure that we're going to have maximum strength, power, speed, but also having that motor learning enhancement. So if we're supplying not only the stimulant to increase those, but we're supplying more of the raw material, the actual ingredient from which those hormones are made, then we're going to have a syngenic effect. It's going to be very, very powerful. And I'll talk about that in future videos. So the quick fix, I use tyrosine and BCAAs in a 1-to-1 ratio. Right now, this is strictly extrapolated theory. We don't have a solid specific ratio. I just want to balance out the BCAAs and the tyrosine. We might actually bump up the tyrosine more. I'll experiment with that. You let me know what your findings are, and then we'll talk about that in future videos. And the key is you have to be protein fasted for this to work. Because if you're consuming protein throughout the day and then you just dump in more amino acids, which a lot of people do with BCAAs, and that's part of the problem, that's why they don't work. They don't actually stimulate muscle protein synthesis to a greater degree. They're not going to have the performance enhancing body comp effects that we want because we have so many other amino acids competing for transport, competing for that access to the CNS, the brain, the spinal cord, and the muscle. So it's like the problem with tryptophan in reverse. So if you have all the amino acids together, it's going to block the BCAAs and the tyrosine, whereas we're actually just trying to block the serotonin producing tryptophan, that key essential amino acid. We want to block that from accessing our brain, our spinal cord as much as possible. And that's again, why we're going to use combination of BCAAs and the tyrosine 1-to-1 ratio. Quick sidebar before we get to the next three steps that you want to take before you optimize these performance-enhancing tips. Now, the idea of a pre-workout that you buy off the shelf that's going to have BCAAs, maybe it does have a little tyrosine, it's probably not going to be enough. If you look at the dose, you look at the grams of BCAAs, and you look at the grams of tyrosine, maybe you don't even know because it's a prop blend, a proprietary blend where they don't actually have to list the doses. Tyrosine can be very expensive, so the dose is likely going to be very low. Now be careful of the other claims, which is that, oh, it's a special type of tyrosine, so you don't need as much. That is nonsense. You just want regular L-tyrosine if you want to use this, and you don't need any special blend. Again, stick that one-to-one ratio with the BCAAs. Now here's your three steps you can take to optimize these tips. Firstly, consider using BCAAs and tyrosine. To be clear, I am a dual certified sports nutritionist. I'm CSCS, registered strength coach with the NSCA. I do not make recommendations or prescriptions, okay? These are not recommendations. I'm just telling you what I do with my clients and athletes, and it's been very successful. So this is all about consideration, just starting to think about using BCAAs, tyrosine for your strength, power, speed. Nextly, if we're going to advance this conversation, really take advantage of this series, we need to start thinking about neurotransmitters and how they're going to impact our performance, not just our cognitive state, not just our ability to focus and that kind of thing, but actually our performance as well. And the good news is neurotransmitters are really just like short-lived hormones used by the nervous system. We're probably familiar with hormones. It's a nice, comfortable concept. Just extrapolate that to neurotransmitters. It's very, very similar. These chemicals bind a receptor to cause an effect. It's very, very similar. Again, it should be very, very comfortable. We don't have to go into a great amount of detail in order to apply the concepts and optimize performance. Because again, we are in the dark ages and we have a huge opportunity for advancement. And I think that's going to be very, very exciting and very, very impactful. And your last tip, if you are serious about improving strength, power, speed, be sure to check out the other videos in this series. Check out that BCA video I talked about earlier. And definitely check out the eccentric training video. It is going to show us how to tap into two-thirds of our strength that we don't even touch. We leave that on the table all the time. It's going to be another paradigm shift. It's going to change the way you think about training. And I'm very excited about this. I think there's a lot of potential that we have yet to optimize. Because right now we're using less than a third of our optimal force potential. And if I told you to train with only a third of your 1RM, you'd think I was crazy, and rightly so. So we need to think sets, reps, forces, and really figure out how to optimize that strength, power, speed. Because we are missing out not just on neurotransmitters, but the actual application of force, how quickly we can do it, and overall, the absolute magnitude of force, the amount of force. So we are going to change that. We are going to fix the other half of our training that we don't normally talk about. I'll link to that in the card in the top right. Be sure to check that video out. So this is very exciting. You have your marching orders. My name is David Barr. Thanks for watching. Until next time, raise the bar.